Hello, and thanks for joining us for this edition of Hope and Heaven's Reflections based on Daily Devotional, written by Pastor E. Adeboye, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. My name is Foyeke Christian Atolani, and I'm so glad to be with you today. I'm a pastor with Christ Love Assembly, a parish of the Redeemed Christian Church of God in Oxford. Our topic today is Shine the Light, and I believe you're familiar with the song, This Little Light of Mine, I'm Gonna Let It Shine. So this topic is really, really relevant. And our Bible passage is Matthew chapter 5, from 14 to 16. You are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hidden. Nor do they light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a lampstand. And it gives light to all who are in the house. Let your light so shine before men, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. Our memory verse is from the same passage, Matthew chapter 5, 16. Let your light so shine before men, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. Our reflections. Following on from yesterday, God has charged us to arise. God is not happy when his children are not fulfilling their purpose in God. God has made us to be his battle axe and weapons of warfare. God wants us to continue to do extraordinary work in our world, but he needs us to do those mighty things for him. God is a good God, and he is still in the business of executing his benevolent acts in our world. God made us light to flush out the darkness in this world. So he also made us the salt to de-escalate the effects of evil and sadness prevalent in our world today. That is why he is challenging us to rise and shine. Being light, he wants us to shine because he's light himself. This cannot be in form of boastful demonstration, but it must be exhibited through the change and difference we are making in our world. To shine means to show the stuff that God made you of. It means show your potential. God has made you and destined you for greatness. So arise and shine to the glory of God. God has also endowed you with great potentials and talents. So make sure you're using your potentials and your talents. You need to arise and shine to show that what potential and talents that God has given to you. The servant in the Bible who did not use his potential was deprived of what he had and was also thrown into utter darkness. You will not end that way in the name of Jesus. God does not want us only to use our potentials. He really wants us to also do exploits for him. To shine means to excel in whatever and wherever God has positioned you. That is why he said in Luke chapter 19, verse 13, occupy till I come. How are you occupying? Are you reigning like a king, or you have become a beggar, abdicating your royal status to the devil? God wants you to shine from today. So arise and shine, for your light has come. When you also shine, your glory may repel your enemies. And in fact, it will repel your enemies. That should not pose any problem to you, because any real light will generate it. If you generate it, unrighteousness will not be able to stand before you. And I pray that from today, unrighteousness will not be able to stand before you in Jesus' name. You are also surely going to be persecuted. That's another thing when you shine. That is bound to happen. So one thing is clear, your light will shine brighter and brighter because your light shines better when darkness is the thickest. My prayer is that you continue to shine to the glory of God, you use your potentials and your talents, and you not be a disappointment in Jesus' name. Our action points. Pray that God will help you to shine more brightly, and may you keep shining to the glory of God in Jesus' mighty name. God bless you, and go out today and shine for the Lord Jesus Christ. And you can sing this song, This Little Light of Mine, I'm Gonna Make It Shine. Bye for now.